What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Stephen Motivate, back again with another set of Turo tips for you. We want to help you run your Turo business well, and so we're back with another set of tips. Hopefully, you're checking out the playlist of all our 52 Turo tips, and it's helping you run your Turo business well. So thanks again for tuning in. Always remember, like, subscribe, let us know what you think, leave comments in the comment section. So let's talk about a question. This is a tip number 23, but it's also a question, like, is Turo worth it? So I get this question a lot. Is how is that business? Is Turo worth it? Is it worth me sharing my car? And the quick answer is no. Turo is not worth it if you don't do it right. Turo is not worth it if you don't do it right. So that's my simple answer. Is Turo worth it? No, it's not worth it if you don't do it right. But the answer also varies, and it's based on your market as well. But even if you're in a good market or bad market, you still need to do Turo the right way. And what do I mean by the right way? Well, I talk about it a lot in these Turo tips, but doing Turo the right way really simply is focusing on economy cars, making sure your prices stay low, and making sure you're not relying solely on Turo to drum up business for you. And so those would be my three things. When people ask, is Turo worth it? Well, if you don't do it that way, then it's certainly not going to be worth it. It's certainly not going to be worth it for you to do Turo if you go and finance a car and you pay the wrong price for it. If you go and get a super luxury car and luxury cars don't work well in your market. And if you don't have the experience of doing Turo and you try to start off doing something that you just don't understand how it's going to play out. And so this is why I tell people, focus on the economy cars. Always have more economy cars than luxury cars. Typically, that works in almost any market. Also, if you really research and do your research ahead of time, do things like check out my Turo tips on YouTube. Look up other Turo hosts on YouTube, other power hosts. These are folks like myself who have a lot of experience running a Turo business. And so it's only worth it if you do it right. And doing it right, really, you should be looking at economy cars. You should be keeping something that you can keep the prices low on and that's easy to maintain. And you should not be relying solely on Turo to generate your business. So tip number 23 is really just an answer to a question. And it's sort of a reminder and maybe even a little synopsis of all 52 Turo tips is that, is Turo worth it? No. It's not worth it unless you do it right. There's a lot of support. There's a lot of groups you can get into that can help you do it right. But if you do it the wrong way, Turo can be a tornado. Turo can be a disaster for you. So you don't want to jump in and not do it right. It's become more saturated. More people are using it. More people are hosting on it. It's becoming more competitive. So Turo is not worth it unless you do it the right way. So take your time, do a ton of research up front. And if you do it right, then it can be worth it and it can be rewarding. There are people who are doing it right. And like we always say, we got to take responsibility. It comes down to management. What decisions are you making or what decisions are you not making that are affecting your business? So that's tip number 23. All right, let's jump into the next tip. Tip number 24. Is 24 hours. Should I be available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week? So availability in Turo. Interesting question. So when I first started, I was available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Whew. Tough times. It's very difficult. You're getting phone calls at 3 a.m, text messages at 5 a.m, people wanting to book your car. And sometimes you feel like that's the only way to do it. I've got to stay always on Turo. And that's not necessarily the case. There is a button within the Turo app. Let me make sure I tell you exactly what it is. So if you go in Turo, under the vehicle section, I think this section is under the vehicle section. You can kind of see it on my screen here. If you look in the top right-hand corner, there's a button called Host Settings. So if you go up to that button in Host Settings and you click on Pickup and Return Hours, you can actually block your availability, indicating which times you're available and which times you're not. And you can also set custom hours. There's a button there that says always available, or you can set custom hours, 9 to 5, 9 to 6. If you get home with your family after 5 o'clock and you don't want to have any more messages about guests, create that setting. You have to test it out and see what it does and see how much business you still get or don't get. But you certainly don't have to be always available, right? If after 9 p.m. you don't want your phone going off asking for a Turo trip, then cut it off. And many times you're avoiding people that are unplanned, a little too spontaneous. They may be younger. They may be moving kind of frivolously. People that will book your car between certain time frames may be a sign that they're not the type of person you want booking your car. Right. So you have to think about not only your sanity and what you're able to manage, but also what type of people are you attracting when you're open 24/7. And so my simple answer for you as a tip, do I have to always be available as a Turo host? No, you don't. You do have to test and see what times work for your market and when availability makes the most sense. But, you know, for several months, we've been available between 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And if you try to book after 6, we're not available. And that's just the way it is. We've also had it where we're always on. And we now have a bigger team, so we can handle always being on. And so it can kind of go either way. But if I'm going on vacation or something of that nature, when my team is off or it's a holiday, you can turn it off. Like, people need to plan in advance in order to be a part of this. And we have enough sales, we have enough customers where we can make those decisions. If you're just starting out, yeah, you can have it always available sometimes just to see what sort of business that generates to get going. I would say look into that, test your market and see what makes the most sense for you. But you do not have to feel like you are required to be always always on. Last tip we'll do for today is tip number 25. Is you need to have automated messages and communications for your renter throughout the trip. So not only do you need automated communications when they book, hey, introduce yourself, tell them a little bit about yourself, why you are even doing the Turo business, create a little bit of affinity or relationship. You're meeting new people, you're meeting strangers, so you never get a second chance to make a first impression. So use this chance to really talk to them, meet them, be brief, but tell something about yourself. And you can set that up in the automatic messaging on the app. And then throughout the trip, you need to check in and say, hey, I hope everything's going well, da-da-da-da-da. Give them some reminders of what they need to do once the trip ends. Make sure everything's going right. You're just checking in and keeping those lines of communication open with them. And it's very easy to do automatically. These messages can be set up automatically within the app. So super important to set that up so you're not having to. When I first started, I was jumping to the Notes app, jumping back to Turo, you know, all my fingers just going crazy, just all over the place, trying to get messages out and respond to customers. Well, now Turo has made it where you have automatic messaging built into the app itself. So you're no longer allowed to use like a third party, but you within the app itself. So you got to make sure you know how to do that. And if you don't know, on the phone, there is a little clock-like timestamp in the upper right hand on an iPhone of the inbox. And so you click on that, and then you're able to go through and look at the templates that you have for messages. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 templates. I have a thank you message. I have a checkout message. I have a check-in message. I have a pre-check-in message. And I have a license request message. So I have all those messages, and they're active for all of my listings. And so I'm able to schedule things that way. With my app, I'm able to go in and schedule what messages trigger to what guests depending on what they do. And so automatic messages are super important. And so you need to be doing that throughout the trip in order to be a good Turo host. You don't just want to let someone share your car and you not communicate with them at all throughout the trip. It's just good hospitality is to show that you're concerned about their trip. Hopefully it's going well for them. See if they have any questions. All that sort of stuff is just good hospitality management. It's what a hotel staff, a premier hotel staff would do. They would make sure the guests are comfortable. So that's another tip for you. Make sure you have automated messages. So that's tip number 25, folks. I hope that helps you the way it helped me. If you like this, remember to like, subscribe, share with somebody else, leave comments. If you know people that are looking for a side hustle, let them know about Turo and give them a link to our 52 Turo tips. As always, this is your boy, Stephen Motivate. Stay motivated. Peace.